10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Team Secrets, turn to pick.
Lifestealer.
Radiant Team Ban.
Game two now between Flipside Tactics and Team Secrets in this European qualifier for the Dota Pit LAN final. This is the grand finals, a best of five between these two teams where Flipside Tactics is already one up. I'm Kaplan's going to be joined by CC and CC. Flipside Tactics definitely got a lineup that they've shown they're very comfortable with. What would you like to see Team Secret do to change and kind of match Flipside Tactics in game number two? Is it a different draft? Do they need to play faster or slower? What is needed to take on Flipside Tactics as the CIS team just seems to be steamrolling through team?
I think last game their draft team fight was just too weak. They couldn't. All their heroes didn't really do that much damage. The TA pick became quite bad after they lost the early game. The Sven pick also worked really well versus the TA. The Lycan didn't really work that well as well. So I think they got outdrafted. This game looks like they're going for the Lifestealer and then pick a carrier afterward. Sort of an unconventional approach. Normally you'd see like them pick a Slaughter or something and then the Nakes afterward, but if you do something like that, they'll typically ban the Lifestealer. So starting with the Lifestealer, then probably going to pick some Slardar or some other Initiator second, because there are so many heroes that can blink in and stun, or heroes that can move the Nakes in. So looks like they are trying to get more aggressive early on, not let Flipside get away with these really greedy teamfight heroes.
We've seen a lot of heroes being run right now. I think the Sven is maybe a little bit more on the farm side, but he definitely hits his, because of the way he jungles and does Ancient, hits his mid-game stride really hard. Phantom Assassin, the build-up with Desolator and those items allows him to go really big into the mid-game. There's another example, the Templar Assassin, I think. Secret obviously failing that last game, but it's another hero that's pretty popular in this meta that has the same kind of mid-game build-up that uses Desolator and hurts, takes on a team fight and can dominate just because of the way you 1, 2, or 3 shot some of these supports. Why isn't Lifestealer being seen more in this patch? Because the Chinese are like picking it up like 1-2 sometimes. Very rarely, as you said, it's a bit unconventional. See Lifestealer picked up in the first 1-2. Usually you pick up the initiator first.
Reserve time. I think teams are just starting to realize that Lifestealer is really, really good right now. The nerfs are like kind of substantial, the ones to his base attack time, some other stuff, but the hero is still the combos, Lifestealer with almost any stunner, especially Slaughter, being able to kill almost any core at any point in the game is just really, really strong. The Lifestealer is very strong in lane, jungle, he can do the Ancient thing. Just an all-around strong hero. He's good versus a lot of cores. Not many cores good versus him. And the Lifestealer, whenever a Slaughter or something like that is picked in the first phase, the Lifestealer almost always bans second phase. We've seen that quite a bit, especially in Dota Pit recently on. So, yeah, I think then they're just realizing that and, trying to get the Lifestealer early on because they do value it, but it's always getting banned in the second phase. 5 seconds
remaining. They also take that Warlock away. Flipside Tactics, they're going to get themselves a nice 4 position. The Earth Spirit, who is notorious for being able to have a pretty good impact on the laning phase, given the right rotations, particularly that mid lane. We don't know what that matchup is going to be just yet, Team Secret. Their choice now. They banned away the Sven and the Morana. Sven, obviously, quite strong versus the Lifestealer. We saw the power of the Warcry against some of the physical damage in game number one. And the Morana, it's kind of one of those new heavy heroes that is very popular right now and has a decent amount of mobility. What are some of the things that you look to counter a Lifestealer pick? Since it is, you know, a core pickup, a carry pickup that's grabbed so early, how do you plan to play around that hero if you're Flipside Tactics?
I mean, typically versus pickoff heroes or heroes that like to burst heroes, you either play aggressive early on and take advantage of that, or you group up a lot and keep them from getting pickoffs. It looks like Flipside is picking a lot of heroes with mobility, heroes with save, the Wisp can heal people up, or Spirit and Nyx, pretty hard heroes to get onto because the Carapace and the Rolling Boulder. So it looks like they're going for more of a just sort of like try and kite the Lifestealer, pick slippery heroes. The Earth Spirit pretty good versus the Lifestealer with the kick and the silence, so yeah, they do take the Slardar. Actually an insane combo, does so much damage at all stages of the game.
Yeah, the amplified damage just seems to prolong the Lifestealer's dominance. That heavy physical damage matching with the minus armor, their dire side as well. So there's obviously a Roshan opportunity here for Team Secret to control that and use it to snowball. Flipside Tactics, they continue along this trend. They've got Nyx Assassin, they've got Earth Spirit. It seems like, as you said, a lot of mobility, but also kind of seems like they're going to try and set the tempo of this game first. Do you want to see them continue down this trend?
I mean, I think at this point they have a whole lot of space makers and not really anybody to take up the space. So probably looking for two more farming cores for their mid and safe lane. You know, their Wisp partner, maybe a Sven again. Pretty good versus these heroes. Maybe a Terrorblade as well. Good versus the Lifestealer as well as the Slardar.
Yeah, I was with you on the Terrorblade. Our Sven got banned away by Team Secret in the 3-4. So Terrorblade makes the most amount of sense, right? Heavy, like just a little bit glass cannons now, but heavy amount of physical damage and really good versus Lifestealer because of that, right? With the illusions and the heavy physical damage and even some extension, the Sunder, you just become a carry that is superior to the enemy's carry, right?
Yeah, and also just a whole lot of armor versus the Slaughter. You know, and if you do get Fatal Bonds down, you can always Sunder an enemy, Sunder a teammate, so good versus Warlock in that Warlock's typically a lot of slow damage, so you can sunder people away. And good versus the Slaughter and the Lifestealer together as well, because he's not really a hero that they can burst down that easily unless they're ahead of the Terrorblade. And if you're ahead as a Lifestealer Slaughter and behind as a Terrorblade, there's already issues.
Ooh, but that you said, hey, Terrorblade, you know, a high amount of natural armor because a heavy agility hero. Well, there's the counter to that right there. Elder Titan picked up for Team Secret.
Yeah, definitely quite good this game. Not great versus the Nyx because you can carapace the Spirit and just stop him from stomping, or carapace the wait to carapace him when he starts channeling the stomp. So good versus him in that regard, but definitely good versus the Terrorblade, putting that Spirit on him from afar. They have a whole lot of initiation, but also a lot of counter initiation. So Secret definitely looking superior in these fights, and Flipside sort of not too many answers versus just. Once again, Team Secret, this game, coming out with a better team fight as opposed to Flipside, who had it last game.
Team Secret, they banned away the Puck. Would have been kind of one of those heroes to maybe give Flipside Tactics the early tempo control. Would have maybe gotten them the edge and kind of kept Team Secret down from their combination being all that powerful. And Voker is going to be under scaling core, though, for Team Secret. I mean, this feels like a pretty natural pickup. Flipside Tactics stand away the Storm Spirit because they kind of had to when there's a Lifestealer. So Flipside Tactics, how do they respond? Is it aggressive mid? Do they play more of a farming style and try and relax a bit? 10 seconds
remaining. I'm not sure. They may try and pick some early fighter and get aggressive on a Team Secret. Because if they don't pressure them early, this Lifestealer and Slaughter are going to go around finding pickoffs. The Invoker is going to help us on strikes and push out lanes. The Warlock could probably sit behind the Invoker. It's just, you know, Flipside doesn't really have that many ways to make moves. So maybe a hero that pairs well with Wisp that can.
Have you seen the mid Ursa versus Invoker? Is there too many cutting?
Batrider. Ursa's kind of just like unplayable versus Slaughter.
Okay.
And also the Warlock, just like too many spells to kite. The Invoker's like it, not great versus this Ursa in the lane, but in the game it's really, really hard for the Ursa, just a whole lot of kiting spells. And it ends up just being sort of too much to run at you, I think, in Nyx Assassin, yeah. Ursa, with just a whole lot of...
So they need a really solid initiation, which is in part right why Team Secret banned away the puck. So instead, Flipside Tactics get themselves a Batrider, a nice controlling hero over the Lifestealer. It can do well in the 1v1 matchup against the Invoker. And, you know, you needed an early tempo controller kind of no matter what, right? Like, you had to be able to make sure Team Secret didn't get the full mid-game swing at 25 minutes with this Lifestealer-Slardar combination.
Yeah, they can't really gank this this Lifestealer though, so he's probably gonna have a good start. The Nyx will, you know, get some farm or whatever, but the Slaughter is definitely gonna have. I mean, the Lifestealer is definitely gonna have free farm. Roger's probably gonna play around this mid lane with the Batrider. Mid one needs to be very careful because that's really the only lane that they can gank super easily. So if he doesn't die there, you know, and give up the give the kills, give the levels to the Batrider, give him a quick blink, then Skirt should be able to execute just fine. Puppy may end up sitting behind mid one as well to defend that. This mid lane should be playing a battleground early on this game.
Do you favor one draft or the other?
Definitely Secret, I think. Flipside is just on so much of a timer. If they don't get stuff done, if they aren't ahead, they just get sort of bulldozed by Secret. And even if Secret's behind, you know, if they have a bad early game, they have a whole lot of team fight to come back. They can still find pickoffs as long as the Slaughter gets a Blink Dagger. It is sort of the only issue with Secret's draft. They don't really have a way to get the Nakes in if Slaughter has a bad game. So if Flipside is able to shut down the Slaughter, keep him like way down, make him get a super late Blink, then they will have a window where Secret isn't really able to get initiations that well. But if he gets a Blink Dagger, this game becomes very rough very fast for Flipside.
Do you think in order to secure that puppy, they should do some sort of like dual lane? Pretty common, right, for Elder Titan to sit in the offlaner with the offlaner and try and boost that laning phase for the first few minutes.
Yeah, it also looks like he bought a stout shield, so looking like they want to go down there and brawl, realizing they need the Slaughter to get a good start.
Well, Puppy is maybe going to get scattered out. Nope, Band's Core. His smoke and push out is just a bit too late, so Puppy's ward may go unnoticed. Going to be nicely placed ward, not blocking anything, but getting a lot of information nice and deep. Flipside doing something similar here. They actually get this top river ward up. What do you think that's necessary for them to get like this kind of ward up for Flipside? Are they want to be able to know what's going on in the jungle? What's the idea behind a ward like that, and why is it so important to get it up early?
I mean, they may not realize that they're probably going to do some sort of dual lane, and they want to see if Puppy's moving between mid and top, because he is sort of the hero that can defend mid one from these rotations from the Earth Spirit. So just sort of giving them some information if they can go on the Invoker or if they're going to get stomped and turned around on. You know, you also just always want to know where the Roamer is. An Elder Titan, a hero that's movements are typically pretty predictable. So seeing where he is really just lets Flipside like go to make the rotations around that and not get countered out by the stomps.
So in other words, it's kind of an ineffective ward if Elder Titan sits bottom.
Yeah, it sort of doesn't really do that much of a do its purpose really, because the Warlock is just gonna sit in full and helps the Lifestealer in lane into a 6 probably, and the Puppy is probably gonna go to this bottom lane because he bought the Stout Shield.
I'm pretty sure Secret's pretty happy with this start. Ferev not only stole the rune, that by itself is good enough, but now Metamorphosis has been popped super early. Really nice choice there by Ferev to battle it out with a trio that has no disables, really.
Yeah, he's going to have to go back to base, so he's going to miss a wave of XP. It's not terrible for Flipside, but by the time he gets back, the Metamorphosis will be down, and it'll be a free lane for him to contest in.
Puppy will make his first appearance here in the mid lane. While the Slardar is away, he feels like mid one already being pressured with 5 Seeking Napalm stacks, needed to make sure the Earth Spirit, who is probably going to be sitting mid a lot, is not able to get a good connection. Fortunately, they do have a really nice ward. Not just this ward that's giving them a lot of information about the Earth Spirit, but this ward as well as seeing this rotation across. So it seems like Midwan's going to be on high alert every single time the Earth Spirit makes a wrap. All the information is available to him.
Yeah, this is not going to be a game where mid one gets a really good start and is able to go around and make a lot of flashy plays. He just needs to play defensive, don't feed away kills, and get as much as you can. It's not going to be a pretty start for the invoker.
Oh, Puppy is going to be gone on. Nice combination here with the Wisp, and they're actually going to block him into the staircase. Slowing him down just a bit. Frev is finally going to get over here. Managed to hit the stun onto Vanskor. Has a tether back up, though. Gets down the cliff to the assistance of Roger. 2-minute rune is coming up. This combination is so deadly. They do manage to get a spirit out, trying to cancel the healing ward of Vanskor. Frev's going to be pushed back by Roger, and the 2-minute rune will be successfully contested by Flipside.
Yeah, their spirit and the Wisp playing together really well, trapping them there, getting a lot of harassment, and sort of like pushing them off the lane, keeping the slaughter from getting XP, having these weird skirmishes on the side. So the Terrorblade definitely having a good start, and the slaughter not really wants to, where he wants to be, having to go back to base for the second time in 2 minutes.
Yeah, that's the really nice part about the Urosphere, right? The fact that if you hit the Rolling Boulder, you appear on the opposite side of the hero. It means this combination with the Wisp gets a guaranteed tether slow every single time and just gives you a lot of extra time to get right-clicks in.
Yeah, the Surf Spirit, just by virtue of being in the game, is putting so much pressure on this Invoker. If he ever gets rolled on and the Batrider's even, you know, within the vicinity, this Invoker just dies, so only one CS right now compared to the Batrider's 15, maybe 16 after this creep.
Damn, you would think with all the vision and, like, their spirit and Wisp kind of battling out in that bottom rune, you'd think he would have had the time to be able to get at least a little bit more CS. Puppy, he may be our first blood, but a nice stun comes out just in time. Puppy will crawl away with just 20 HP. Away from the Terrorblade and Wisp. Metamorphosis used, Sidoi will fully control the lane now.
Yeah, he doesn't know where the Earth Spirit is, but it's gotten to the point where Tame My Wild has gotten boots now, and Midone doesn't have boots, so he can even threaten solo kill, so Midone has to play very, very defensive, even whenever he knows it's just the Batrider in the lane, because giving up a solo kill early on is the worst thing that can possibly happen for Secret.
Midone. Conservative style continues as he knows Roger is just around the corner. Even sends a Forged Spirit to chase him away. Anytime he's got like two stacks on him, right, he has to start backing up.
Yeah, it's not a fun existence right here, but Midone is playing it like he needs to. Just getting extremely little, but not dying. That's the most important part. Because his Batrider is going to get free CS regardless, but making sure he doesn't die to these Air Spirit ganks. They're at only two at this point, and really no way to get XP if he doesn't get these rotations. So Midone really sacking himself this game, but playing very well, making sure he doesn't give up kills.
Well, eventually, Midone does need some help, and Puppy is going to be here. He's going to make his first rotation with level 2 ready to go. It's only until he has that stomp that he can actually do something here, but a nice scan comes out. Managed to get the successful read. We'll see if Flipside try and go on mid one anyway, but I highly doubt it. They don't want to be caught out by an Echo Stomp underneath the tier one tower.
Yeah, they really, really, really want this kill though. Like, you can tell this Earth Spirit just...
He's not letting it go, man. He wants it bad. They're actually going to TP up the top lane. Nyx Assassin is in a bit of trouble, but now he's going to be saved. A nice two-man stun followed up. Pylai die, first to go down. First blood, NP turns against the three-man, but realizes neither one of the side heroes is low enough for them to actually make it go. Maybe actually Shachlo almost goes down with the help of Fatal Bonds, but the stomp doesn't land, and they will both stay alive still. Nice rotation out from Flipside. Probably didn't expect that one. Top lane, they think they're trying to push the Nyx Assassin out, make a good go on him, and all of a sudden two supports show up out of nowhere.
Yeah, very nice rotation. Double TP, so it does come at a cost. They do get the first blood, but Slaughter is going to have a whole lot of free XP in this bot lane. And Invoker also is able to sort of catch up on the XP Puppy around here, so in my wall.
Oh, nice stomp into the Sunstrike. And Midone finally gets his vengeance, man. He's my... This Batrider's been dumping on me the whole entire landing phase, but I haven't died. They finally make a connection with the successful gank of Puppy.
Yeah, that kill is absolutely huge. Him being up as many CS as he was, Midone playing extremely safe, it's so hard mentally to be okay with having two CS when you know the other person has complete free farm. But just staying back, making sure he doesn't die, and then, you know, getting as many levels as he can, getting the level 5, 3 level Sunstrike, and Puppy coming in for the gank. Now they're on even footing again, even after that atrocious landing stage. So Midone with, like, really, really good strength of mind to not go up for more last hits and feed.
Yeah, you can see he's only 200 net worth behind, despite obviously a very large CS differential. Like, Gank met everything, and there may be another one. Puppy is still kind of setting up. Pylai Dai is here as well. You really want to get Midwan ahead. Puppy's going to lead the way. The Echo Stomp is going to land. Batrider will be hit here by the Sunstrike. Follow up with a little bit of extra damage from the Cold Snap, slowing him down. Damage over time with the Warlock helps control the Batrider, but the Wisp Heals are superior. Keeps Tame My Wild ahead of this gank, and the supports from Flipside rotate in. Secret already backed up, though. Stun comes out from Shachlo. Does land on the Warlock, but nothing's going to come of it. They can't really dive the Tier 1 tower again. Not against an Elder Titan.
Yeah, Tame My Wild, skill building very much for these early fights, trying to get aggressive and get kills on Midwan, but just like completely countering that once again by not dying. So Batrider not really able to farm jungle stacks that well right now with the 3-2-1 build.
Yeah, is this this is something that, who was it, like maybe Moonmander was talking about on Twitter or something with a recent change. You know, he used to go like no levels of Flaming Lasso, and you go through a drum build and you just try and like maximize your basic abilities. Forev almost goes down, actually will. The last hit comes out from Sido just barely. Even swaps around a little bit of HP. Roger smokes up, almost hit by the stomp. That was going to lead into a Sunstrike, but Roger, with that clutch play, will manage to get out. Nyx's Assassin has gone on at the top lane by the Lifestealer, but now is going to be turned around on by Tame My Wild. Push back straight into the Tier 1 tower. A little bit of extra magic damage, and it's enough. Physical damage comes out from the tower to finish off the Lifestealer at 1 HP. I can't believe that play by Roger, though. That was pretty clutch. Realizing the scenario he was in, if he's hit by Stomp, he's hit by Sunstrike, so he smokes up like that.
Yeah, that was really, really smart.
They're going to rotate on to mid. This time around, the vision is gone from Midwan. He may finally be caught by this gank, but Puppy's kind of lurking behind Midwan, stalking him, seeing if there is a gank that comes in. Kick back, he's there, ready to go with a stomp, and saving Midwan's life. Sure enough, three-man stomp is good enough. MP's actually going to try and punish here. Comes in with the open wounds. Rogers gets stunned up by the cold snap, and MP and Puppy beat the support down, punishing him for a failed gank on Midwan.
A really nice turnaround, and all this time, Pylai Dai almost is level 6 top, so almost getting to that point where they can start taking fights and defending these towers much easier. Forev also getting some free space bottom while the Terrorblade does some jungle camps.
Everything's looking pretty good for Team Secret. We both kind of felt like their draft was a bit superior, and the laning phase, the kind of plays they're making, as you said, like Midwan playing the correct kind of conservative style until the ganks finally come in from the supports. They're not giving away too much, but we haven't really seen the entrance of Shachlo just yet, and he does have his level 6. His first gank is going to be targeted toward Forev, who's had a pretty free time against Sidoi 1v1 most of the laning phase, as both support duos have been sitting behind mid most of the time. Doesn't look like they're going to catch Forev, though. He managed to get a call out from somebody saying the Nyx Assassin is missing. Everybody seems to be playing pretty conservatively right now for Secret.
That's just sort of how they need to play. This game is very much, if you don't die to all their ganks and stuff, then give up kills and towers to the early pressure, then the game just gets pretty easy for Secret. Even with just tick gold, the Sada will get the blink pretty early, so if he doesn't give up a lot of kills, then he will get this blink at a reasonable timing.
Currently just trying to slow down the push, but doesn't seem like there's going to be too much commitment. Maybe Forev's going to be caught, though. Roger jumps in. Pylai Dai is forced to drop the Golem just to try and save Forev, but it's not good enough. NP TP'd in. Went straight for Banscore. Sunstrike not going to land, but it's not needed anyway. Sidoi, half HP, has the Sunder ready to go. The stomp. Oh, TP out is successful. Flipside, not able to get the Tier 1 tower. Team Secret not giving it up, and also creating a lot of space for this Invoker as he continues to sit mid lane as the full 5-man of Flipside fails to push in.
Yeah, the level 2 Forge Spirits now, so if they don't come back pretty quickly, he will take this tower. But Batrider coming in, they have the Sentry and the Wards, they know he's here, so stopping any potential gank, maybe gonna try and turn around.
But the dust already to go. Ferev is going to make a quick stun on the Batrider. The stun comes down from the Earth Spirit, but not going to be enough. Even Bantscore's in serious trouble. The Amplify damage, Sunstrike on the mark. Ferev nails him first with the Crush. And even with that rotation, they'll still be able to get some good damage on that tower. MP, he goes straight for Seedoid, but now the swap around between the Vendetta hit as well as the Sunder. Shashlo's hoping to wait for that Rage to pop out, land the stun. The slow's there. The stun will land because of it. 5-6 now as they get a little bit of a punish on Pain MP at bottom lane.
Yeah, super nice play from Ferev. Seeing the guys walking across with the sentry really well placed and immediately buys a dust while he's TPing in. So super fast reactions, runs over and gets the free kill on the Batrider. A really, really nice turnaround on this bat. Not a game where you can be behind on a Batrider and it'd be okay. So super nice play from Ferev, but sort of equalized by the kill on MP, getting a little more aggressive.
Yeah, essentially trying to make too many plays happen, right? The kill on mid, as you said, perfect. Slows down the Blink Dagger, keeps the flip side aggression at bay. But Seedoid definitely made a chunk of change. Was it Seedoid? No, it was actually Shachalo who picks up that kill. Either way, they both enjoyed the experience, and Seedoid will get some space to actually take this tier 1 tower finally.
Yeah, he is a very, very rich Terror Blade, so... Besides, Beacon of Hope in this game, able to take down a lot of these early towers with the Treads and the Dragonlance, level 4 in his Illusion and his Metamorphosis, so dealing a metric ton of damage to this tower.
Nyx Assassin wrapping around behind the mid tower. Counter Ward's going to be laid down though. Pylite die. Not going to die today. Spots out the Nyx Assassin's gank, and now they're going to TP rotate to bottom lane and make sure their tier 2 tower doesn't go down to the Metamorphosis up Terrorblade. You said Terrorblade pretty damn farmed, you're right, 6,500 over the 4,600 that is currently sitting on both the Lifestealer and the Invoker. I was going to ask you a question, but it looks like we're going to have a fight top first. Tier 1 tower goes down, the roll misses though, because currently a Lifestealer is sitting inside the range creep. The rest of Flipside pushes forward, hoping to be able to catch Midwan instead, but a stomp slows them down. They may still catch Midwan, though. He's napalmed up. Tame My Wild managed to get the lasso, actually just sitting over him, over the goal of stun. Will be able to get the kill. Pylite die, trying to help out as best as possible, but it looks like Flipside Tactics may just run over these heroes. MP finally pops out of his infested creep, goes for Roger, will manage to nail him. 2-3 so far. Team Seeker coming out on top in this engagement. Flipside getting too aggressive. As soon as the boulder missed, they still continue to go for that kill, and it cost them dearly, fighting into Pylite Dye's Warlock Golem.
Yeah, they sort of forgot that MP was in that creep, so he comes from behind, picks off a couple of the supports, kills Vanskor first, so not able to save the other heroes. And mid one, microing his Forge Spirits after the death, so getting, you know, 5, 6, 7 volleys of attacks off and really chipping down the squishier heroes, lowering the Bat's armor, so over the Warlock did. The Warlock Golem did come over, just sort of whomped him for a whole lot of his HP and took him down.
So the Terrorblade is the big threat, right? They kept, you know, the Batrider down for the most part, and eventually he'll get his items. But, oh, kick back, nice play. Midwan in some serious trouble with the relocate in. Midwan's definitely dead, he knows that. And that's why he just turns and tries to get the kill on Roger. He does make it a successful 1-for-1.
Yeah, they're going to take the mid tower off of that. So, really nice rotation. The Wisp getting 6 not too long ago, now almost 7 off of that kill. That's the stuff Flipside needs to sort of keep doing, making these plays, getting aggressive, but Ferev finally has his Blink Dagger, so threat is live.
Yeah, this whole team fight dynamic could change in an instant. It used to be Secret could only win fights with Chaotic Offering, but now with a Blink Tech, they're going to find their initiation to go straight for the Assassin. Already one down, and Secret quick to retreat. Flipside may still be able to catch Ferev, though. He's got Sprint up in a second, but he's slowed down by the Napalm. He almost has his Blink up. The right clicks just keep on coming in. They put the Courier on him, making sure get as much vision as possible over Ferev, but he finally does manage to make a Blink away. 30 HP. If he's nailed by one Spirit, he'll die here. Vanskor is just feet away from being able to get this kill. Roger also rolling in, looking for this kill, but Ferev, the sneaky fish, will stay one step ahead of Flipside Tactics. He blinks himself away a second time, and Secret go unpunished for their initiation on the Nyx Assassin.
Yeah, and while he scuttles around, the TB's ult is down, so That really, really nice pickup on the back lines buys enough time for them and Orphis to wear down, so not able to take that tier 2, although it is quite low.
So is this how you play around the Terror Blade? You just kind try and get these picks and slow down the Metamorphosis pushes? That's what really what I was getting into, right? He's the biggest threat. How do you play around him?
Yeah, you just have to, the other heroes, eventually it'll get to the point where whenever all of his team is dead, no real supporting cast, they'll be able to kite him around with the Invoker spells, stomp after stomp after stomp, crushing him. We have enough kiting spells once his team's dead, so not really focusing him, but sort of trying to kite him as much as they can, throw some disables on him, and blow up the rest of the team.
Yeah. Kill the back line as many times as possible. Flipside Tactics, they just lost their Earth Spirit on a mid attempt. The kills in this game just won't stop. We have 20 kills in total in 17 minutes. Flipside put a bit of pressure on the tier 1 tower, but don't have Metamorphosis. So they're not going to fully commit. The jump in though for Ev, he managed to find the Vanskor Wisp, but a nice stun comes out from Shotchlo at the right time. No rage being used by MP. Means Vanskor will be able to tether his way out. And that's an Infest Blown. As well as two heroes top, it seems like Flipside Tactics, this could be a good time for them to push down that top lane, knowing that Infest is on cooldown for a bit of time. They managed to get the relocate onto mid lane. Looks like they're trying to make the initiation with a Batrider. Byelai Dai had a nice response though with Chaotic Offering. MP in the meanwhile does manage to get the Nyx Assassin, who is trying to sneak his way in with a Vendetta while the relocate came in at the same time at mid. Bit of miscommunication is going to cost them dearly as they're still going to lose their wisp. The initiation comes out. Metamorphosis though too much for MP to handle. He gets a bit too over aggressive and gives away his life to the carry of Seedoy.
Yeah, whenever they made that initial Nyx Bomb gank on the Wisp and the Nyx here, Shotchlo made a really, really nice play. He was out of range from the Infest damage, but he walked back into it and spiked Carapace. So it stunned him on the initial Infest pop-out, so he couldn't get his rage off and kill the Wisp. It was a really, really nice play.
Nicely played by Nyx Assassin. Flipside Tactics will finally get this tier 1 tower. A bit of a delay. Again, I wasn't sure where that relocate was going at first with the way that Nyx Assassin was scouting top. Seemed like that whole entire idea is a bit of miscommunication, right? They can't be trying to scout two areas at once and go for a relocate. Kind of cost them too much. They split up. They still get the tier 1 tower, but a couple of like that, they cannot afford against Team Secret, who are just slowly but surely building up a strong mid-game team. They've got a decent experience advantage and a slight gold lead despite the number of towers that Flipside have currently controlled.
But in a game like this, where your lineup is so centric around the early game and this mid-game and putting a lot of
Stun and countered out by Ferev and MP's combination, Pylai Dai will be saved once again. Roger, getting away. Vanskor may not be as lucky. Tethers to Seedoy. Ferev misses out on the stun. Meanwhile, Nyx Assassin gonna be caught once again, rolled over by the meteor. Flipside have lost two of their cores and are forced to retreat. Ferev still looks for more though. Roger's gonna be nailed by a crush and a sunstrike. Long roll away, but Ferev on hot pursuit. A good relocate out will save Roger, but it may not save our Wisp. Earth Spirit's going to try and get in position to be able to allow the Wisp to tether away. They're going to need an instant stun for Ev. He, with the amplify damage, they see where Roger's at, so they just kill Roger instead, and the Wisp gets away. But all that, Vanskor used a relocate to save Roger. He still dies anyway. So Flipside just end up with a relocate down.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. In a game like this where Flipside needs to be ahead early, gold being even is definitely secret favored. Flipside needs to have an advantage in this game for them to be in a good position. But whenever the game is on even footing, the Slaughter has his Blink Dagger now. So as you can see, the Flipside just been hemorrhaging kills all over the map, and it's really, really hard not to.
Chaotic Offering used, dropped there, as once again, our Nyx Assassin is being scouted out by these counter wards from Secret.
Yeah, it's multiple times. The one on this by this bottom room, that sentry, the sentry there, the sentry up top, by the top tier one, just really, really nice counter warding. And off these kills, Puppy already has a hood up, so sort of buffing up their tank ability so that they can't get down these initial heroes with their burst, and then Seeker can just continue to just chase them down with Slaughter stuns and really optimizing or itemizing well for these fights. Seeker definitely comfortable with the position they're in.
trying to deal with a gigantic illusion army of Seedoids here. He found himself an illusion rune, secret. Looking all around for kills as they've got this Lardar Lifestealer combination ready to go. A deadly duo that can pretty much guarantee to kill almost anybody on Flipside Tactics if they find the right person. Shachlo is sneaking around as the Nyxed Assassin, hoping, praying that he won't run into another Counter Ward, but it's going to be mid where initiation is at. Roger. Oh my god, that is a chunk of HP, MP. Slices and dices support across Flipside Tactics may just lose a Roshan because of that, because it looks like Secret want to dip their head in there. They've got the amplified damage, they've got the physical damage, they really have everything they need to be able to do Roshan in a jiffy.
Yeah, mid one breaking the Lincolns with the Yule, so able to get the open wounds and the amplified damage off. Rosh is just gonna drop super fast. Flipside trying to put some pressure on this top lane, but if heroes off the map, they could be Roshaning, but it's not for sure. And if they are Roshaning, they'll be done very, very quickly, so dangerous to push top.
So they can still TP potentially, but never mind. They're not even gonna try. Instead, it looks like they're just gonna try and claim bottom lane, and they'll be I thought they were gonna be successful, but never mind. Tame I Wild, quick with the fingers, does manage to blink ahead of Rev's Crush. Still, though, that rotation should get them the tier 1 tower, and this TP probably needs to be canceled. Shachlo, fortunately, no countervision there, so won't be caught. In fact, it's gonna make his initiation. Two-man stun to lead things off with the fire damage over the top. Flipside Tactics coming in with a very big metamorphosis up Seedoid, but he doesn't actually have the disables anymore to lay out the damage. The relocate perhaps just a bit too far behind to take control, take advantage of that control from the Nyxed Assassin, rather.
Yeah, the Terrorblade having a Diffusal Blade now, so when the Nyxed Assassin, or when the Lifestealer's Rage is down, he does a whole lot of damage, so Flipside still with avenues into this game, this Terrorblade being absolutely massive. Zero deaths, four kills, three assists. Seedoid playing really, really well with that good laning start he had. Taking a lot of Secrets Towers, but if he ever makes a mistake and goes down to a Slaughter Bomb combined with a Sunstrike, or, you know, if the teamfight goes poorly, he's able to get chased down, this game will go downhill very, very quickly for Flipside.
Echo Saber for the Lifestealer. These like three items seem to just kind of like make this meta right now. So many strength heroes and even some agility heroes taking advantage of the cheap Desolators, damage that it provides, cheap cost. Echo Saber, great for all these strength heroes. See, this Lifestealer, now that he's got all three items, Armlet, Desolator, as well as Slardar down, Team Secret should be able to take some control of the mid game, but Flipside still have some notorious pickoff of the Batrider leading the way. See the Slardar going down, and they're gonna try and push forward into the tier 2. It's fine, Carapace trying to catch that that Elder Titan. He's gotta be a bit careful with where his spirit's at, otherwise he could easily be caught out.
Yeah, Shachal almost a really nice play. Tried to get the stun off, but probably just a little bit too far away. Almost could have been a pickoff and maybe leading into the tower and more, but quite there.
Our next Metamorphosis is coming out. How did you like Flipside to kind of structure this next? Because they can't just like run down towers, right? Secret's a little bit strong, so you want to look for pickoffs first. How do you structure that?
I mean, it probably has to be either the Batrider or the Nyxed looking for pickoffs, but it's sort of hard, them just wandering around. They sort of have to define the initiations near towers and have the relocates by that, so they have some sort of fights aren't too chaotic, but
Seedoid just gonna be blown up. Secrets, I mean, that was a little bit of nice fortune, simply because they smoked up, they got an invis rune on NP, and he was able to run straight into the wisp and three-shot him, making sure that there was no relocate out save by Seedoid, but what Team Secret did there anyway. Oh, and they're gonna find more. They're stuck on the cliff, though, because of this one. Four step up in 12 seconds.
Oh, taking the bat. Oh, Shachal took the gem.
Oh, nice. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Yeah, they can't actually take advantage of these heroes being stuck on the cliff. Come down in a second now, but tier 2 tower gonna be sacrificed because of that. Team Secret and their pickoffs taking control of the game now.
Yeah, they're probably gonna run bottom immediately after as well, still having this Aegis. No rock, but the Batrider is still down for 20 seconds, so bot tower should be a freebie as well. The rock already killing the Radiant wave and pressuring the tower, so two towers off of those pickoffs.
And now we see that gold graphs start plummeting downwards. It was somewhat even before, and that was with Flipside Tactics having a pretty decent tower lead. They had like one or two towers up over Secret. Now that the Paycoffs start going the way of Secret, they start taking control of the game and taking these objectives. The gold just plummets downwards to a 7,500 gold lead now for Secret and almost 10k experience.
Yeah. The way those first couple of picks played out was really, really nice by Secret. Seeing the Wisp and the Nyx Assassin, I realized they want to play for more of a pick-off style, having Nyx set up for ganks and stuff, and taking their Warlock, and then going into the Lifestealer and the Slaughter afterwards. Just sort of countering the way Flipside wanted to play the game and forcing them to make an audible last minute. But really just too late to alter the draft enough, and Secret just...
Sorry, do you remember what Flipside's 3-4 bans were?
It was like Sven Potom, was it? No, I think Secret banned Potom. It was Sven something, I think.
Yeah, that feels... when Secret already showed the Lifestealer, right? It seems like... I know there are probably, you know, there's so many initiating heroes that you can get, but surely you would ban away, like, when I see a Lifestealer first, I'm thinking, like, okay, Slardar is obviously the first go-to, most powerful with Lifestealer.
Oh, and no, it was Axe Bounty. They banned Axe Bounty.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay, that makes sense. Axe is one of the better initiators, right, for a Lifestealer, and then Bounty Hunter kind of sets up those kind of ganks, I guess.
Yeah, but I'm still, like, really surprised they didn't ban Slardar. Like, that's the most infamous of the... of the stun initiators, and also just a really, really top tier pick right now. One of the best stuns in the game. 8-second cooldown, 2-second stun, two and a half, and then a 2-second slow after that. Just kind of ridiculous that hero's stuns, if he can get off to a start, it doesn't get crushed early on.
They've got a little bit more control coming out. The Lifestealer has completed his basher. Sitting back in the inventory, though, as Vrev and MP are currently looking for a pick at bottom lane, expecting someone to poke their head out, maybe just do a little bit of a push. It would be punished immediately, but Flipside Tactics are not taking the bait. Not yet, anyway. They're staying as a five-man in mid lane, going for a Lucian's push. I'm guessing, yeah, the map looks pretty dark for them right now. They have these nice aggressive wards sitting up at top lane, but it's the bottom half of the map they know Secret could be occupying, so they're staying away from that and maybe expecting a rotation across.
Yeah, and just this Lifestealer, just by being in the game, this Slaughter Lifestealer, there's really nowhere that they can go. They all just have to sit around here and hope somebody farms a little too aggressively and they get a pick off and maybe move out, but... they don't see Secret's heroes farming the jungle, smoking around, and just making themselves scary on the map. Flipside just has nowhere really to farm. Gonna try and smoke through their jungle and clear it out, but Secret's not there, so just a waste of a smoke and more time as this gold graph plummets downwards more.
Flipside clear through their own jungle. They're gonna check into the Roshan pit, but it is not even potentially up just yet. Well, another 2 or 3 minutes until that's ready to go. Aghanim's is now up for mid one, so he's hitting the full strength of the Invoker. He had the Blink Yules earlier. Now he's level 16 with an Aghanim Scepter. This is where the Invoker truly becomes a team fight menace.
Yeah, is they have some ways to kill this Invoker. They have the Nyx Assassin that can, you know, carapace on a lot of the spells, maybe get a stun off, but we don't have any Yules to be defensive, so. If he's not controlled massively, then he's probably going to be able to get off a whole lot of spells and really kite Flipside and make these fights just even more awful than they already are. It's just so hard for Flipside not to get disintegrated by Secret's initiation.
But there is some upside still, the Flipside, right? They have one of those lineups that if they win one team fight and it's on Secret's side of the map, they can easily just, you know, pummel through tier 2s and tier 3 towers. Relocate's gonna come in top after a failed initiation. Rev trying to carry MP to safety here, but he's gonna get lassoed up. MP pops out with a rage, but Tame My Wild's a bit too fast for him. The Golem got dropped by Flipside Tactics, are still able to push through. Tame My Wild hoping to be able to slow down MP. Looks like it's just Pylai Dai who may be the pickoff here. Tame Mind Wild doesn't actually cut him off, but it looks like Shachlo will still be able to close that distance. Mid one actually turned on Roger's Earth Spirit, got that kill. Pylai Dai is finally going to go down here as he gets stunned up, and Seedoy gets the damage in to finish him off. A 1-for-2 simply because Mid one found an opportunity here with the Ghost Walk, and actually he's going to look for more here. Blinks forward as Vanskor tornadoes him out. One more right click will finish him off, and he TPs away. Mid one, what a player. He knows flip side are hunting down Pylai Dai, and he sneaks in through the side and catches both supports, evening that fight up 2-2.
Yeah, that was some nice fancy plays, but that was like the dream scenario for flip side. The Slaughter misses the crush, overextends. They get the Slaughter first. The Lifestealer wastes his rage, and still, and Puppy wasn't there, and still, it's only, you know, a 2-for-2 after mid one, getting some nice pickups on the back line. Showing, you know, they also had the relocate behind them with the TB. Just really, really hard for them to lock people down once they've used their disables, and everybody just sort of walks away.
50 seconds until a Metamorphosis is back up. Fortunate timing for Flipside, though. It's not going to be too early of a Roshan. Metamorphosis being up will time quite well in sync with Roshan coming alive.
Yeah, Seeker will be able to kill that in 2 or 3 seconds, most probably. The Deso, the Amp damage, and the Invoker's Alacrity. Gonna melt like butter.
And this is probably a Roshan that Flipside cannot afford to give up, right?
Yeah, I think they may have to fight this one. It's really, really hard, though. So you could have the Spirits around there. On flip side, have some okay Roshan heroes, and the Batrider, and the Earth Spirit can kick stuns into the pit from far away. It's just super difficult versus the vision from the Elder Titan, and then also Secret having wards around that area.
Like the way that Secret is currently controlling the area around the Roshan pit, keeping Flipside down to this low ground area as best as they could. Couldn't actually find a pickoff though, the Slardar and Lifestealer combination doesn't actually do it. They poke their head into Roshan, they see it's now up, but they know they shouldn't try and do it straight up. Flipside very clearly want to contest Roshan. Don't want to get caught inside the pit. It all comes down to this initiation. Flipside can make their way back into this game if they get the right jump, and they've got it too. Slardar, he's going to be pulled back. A rage wasted. MP is going to try and close the distance with Tame by Wild. He does get him. BKB popped by Seedoy, though, and as he now battles it out with MP, Roger in the background being incredibly dismantling, but Invoker just lays waste to the Nyx Assassin, almost finishing him off, and Will with a tornado on the right-hand side already. We have Nyx Assassin down as well as Roger. We will manage to finally get a kill for Seedoy, but now he has to man up against MP without the Wisp as he quickly goes down to the physical damage, ends up dying 2-5. A full wipe by Team Secret. They take control of this game, and as a consequence, we'll be getting Aegis into their hands.
Yeah, once again, it's just sort of what happens in these fights. Secret just plays around the Terror Blade. They lose some heroes because of the massive damage, the Defusal Blade, and all the illusions. Seedoy is super farmed, but it just doesn't really matter. They kill a supporting cast that is not quite so farmed, and then save him for last, and then makes just 3 shots in whenever he's amped, and with no Wisp to help him.
Yeah, would they give MP that, the Alacrity as well? Jesus. He looked so scary. Once he, he popped out, you know, he's raged. And I thought, oh, that's going to be a wasted rage. But he still managed to get the open wounds on the Batrider, and he had the Alacrity on him, and he just tore Tame My Wild apart so quickly. It was like 3 or 4 shot him.
Yeah, he also has his Abyssal Blade now as well, so it can maybe even go on the Terror Blade. Not really going to have a chance to Sunder or get up his BKB with the hard stun.
Was there anything really notable that Flipside Tactics failed in that fight? Because it started off really well, right? The initiation was apt. They got the Slardar with the Batrider. That's kind of like the dream start too, right?
Did they kill him initially? Like, or was he able to walk away and sort of like force them to chase him for a bit? Because I think the Batrider was a little bit far, or the Flipside was a little bit far, either one. So they weren't able to kill him in the last, though. Am I right, or am I?
Yeah, that sounds about right, especially with the way that Lifestealer was able to actually get the Batrider immediately. I think he acted as a little bit of a zoning force.
Yeah,
oh, Tame My Wild caught. It's going to be a rough pickoff here. He's got the Shadowblade, though. Maybe Secret don't have any. Oh, never mind. Ooh. Here's the gem.
Oh, I thought that was his Yules. Okay, that was mid ones. Yeah, there's no way he's living.
Yeah. Well, there's an AC for Terrorblade. So what, they just gotta make sure they're a little bit more grouped up when they make that initiation?
Yeah, I mean, if they catch the Slaughter, they have to blow him up in that in the last iteration, or he's just gonna scuttle away. They're gonna have to chase and use more resources. While Seeker just continues, mid one just like playing around in these back lines, killing the Wisp, killing the Earth Spirit, just tearing them apart. They really, really have to have very structured fights and go from one hero to the next, just blowing them up in unison. Because if these fights break up, sort of like they did in this open area, Seeker just jumps heroes, runs away, just continues to go in and out, in and out, in and out, and Flipside doesn't really have the tools to deal with that.
On the hunt for Rev and MP. Make the Nyx Assassin disappear like Houdini. They've got one pick off and a push coming in at the top lane. A reload came out from Vanskor, but I believe that was supposed to bring the Terrorblade with him. Either way, maybe it was smart that he didn't bring him. 3 more seconds till the relocate back. Rev's gun's coming up. Oh, not quite fast enough. It looks like he may survive. Has to get back to the fountain first. God, the heals. He's good. He's good. All right. He'll stay alive.
Meanwhile, mid one finding a pickoff on Roger, so continuing to assert his dominance on the map.
They weren't able to get too much damage on that tier 3, though. They still waiting for that one really big pickoff that allows them to go high ground with this Aegis. They've got 2 more minutes for it, and the pickoff, I think they just found it. Seedoy in some serious trouble. They don't have a relocate, so they're going to force the BKB charge out of Seedoy. Oh, mid one might have been. He's careful. He actually just jumps in a little bit too far. They blow up mid one. Now MP. He has to battle up against Seedoy. Seedoy stunned up for the moment by the Abyssal Blade, but the rest of Flipside, now that the Rage is down, MP is theirs. Rage is still down when it comes back up. 2 seconds, but the kick immediately lands. Can they combo this one up? They defuse the blade him, but now the stun comes in from Ferev on a 2. They've amplified up Seedoy as well. He needs some help, but he can't get away from MP, who stays on top of him until a 2-man stun. Seedoy turns. He takes them both down. Team Secret lose 3, as well as the Aegis. Flipside Tactics, finally. They've been on the losing side of so many engagements for the last 10 minutes, but finally they win one.
Yeah, just way too aggressive from MP. The BKB already forced out, so probably just better to back up and for that to be down, but now has to use up the buyback. Probably gonna get relocated in by the Wisps. Oh, maybe not. Okay, he has to be bought bots, so they're gonna try and get as much damage as they can during this time where the Lifestealer and the Slaughter are down. Only buyback on the Slaughter, so no buyback on Lifestealer. They may actually be able to get the tier 3, but I don't think they're gonna get racks off of this. Too much defensive potential from the Stomp and then Invoker spells.
Yeah, and lack of Metamorphosis too, right? That's gonna hurt Flipside's. Okay, maybe they're not even gonna get any damage on this tier 3. Warlock zoning him out really well with this upheaval, making the high ground push a real pain in the ass for Flipside Tactics. And Slardar's up now, 15 more seconds until the Lifestealer's up. I don't think Flipside Tactics want to get caught attempting any more damage on that tier 3 tower, so they back themselves away.
Yeah, they take what they get, so nice free kills. Not really a way to push into the upheaval, the invoker spells, the stomps, crushes, all that stuff way too hard. So they just have to keep doing what they're doing, playing really safe, not getting caught, minimizing casualties, and punishing overextensions. That's the best way they have to get back into this game.
Is there anything else you can do as Seedoy to shore yourself up against this natural order amplify damage combination? Is there any other armor item he could realistically get? Because the AC by itself is basically covering amplify damage. The rest of his natural armor is being covered up by natural order.
Not really, to be honest.
So no. He's just kind of screwed. He's all, every single fight, he's going to be sitting at zero armor, basically.
Yeah, I mean, it's nice in theory, but a lot of times you aren't really able to get the Spirit on the Terrorblade. He's really fast at this point with the bots, so 456 movement speed, even with the Tranquils on, the Spirit not as fast, so, you know, he just has to sort of play around it. It is very tricky to keep the Spirit on him, so not at that bad. And I mean, if they're getting to the point where he's getting crushed and has the Spirit on him, the fight's probably going to go badly anyway.
Flipside start making their way back to base. Earlier, we almost saw a pick there from Ferev and MP. Almost running into Tame Live Wild. That would have been not just a core pick, but also the gem from Flipside Tactics taken away. Currently, Vision, very important part of this game, Secret. They've got some nice aggressive vision down Flipside Tactics. They got some aggressive vision down earlier, but to their benefit, both the side lanes are pushing, and I think it's going to force Secret back, as sure enough, they give up on that mid-push and attempt at a pickoff. Deal with the side lanes first. No reason to give up any Tier 3 tower damage. They don't have to.
Yeah, Cito actually selling his Dragon Lance, so getting the Butterfly now. Waited for them to move away so we could get the Secret shot, but...
Whoa, Roger gonna be picked off. Revan MP finally do find a kill, but a support doesn't really mean too much. Certainly doesn't mean that they can go for a high ground push right away.
Yeah, doesn't really do that much at all, but the T does have his Butterfly now, so he's basically maxed out for all intents and purposes.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, he's definitely very strong, and like in that last fight, if they can keep him alive, if he can kite around enough, then he can definitely deal with some serious damage. Just a matter of if his team can live long enough for him to deal it out.
Well, until MP gets an MKB, they've got at least that significant invasion to the hands of the Terrorblade over MP when he starts getting targeted. But these items, they'll help, but really the initiation is the most key part of these team fights, right?
Yeah, for sure. If Flipside can get a jump off onto this Invoker or the Slaughter or something like that, or even the Lifestealer, they can obliterate him if the TB is in hitting range. And Flipside actually have a good shot at these fights, but if Seeker gets the jump, then Flipside is gonna have some issues.
Jump inside the Slardar and smoke up, push out. Tame My Wild is going to pop for Rev. Oh, blink for blink. Not able to get the initiation on the Batrider that they needed. Tame My Wild playing an excellent scouting force so far in this game. Secret, though, are still pushing out like they want to fight, even though the smoke has been spoiled. Flipside Tactics holding the high ground right now, waiting for Team Secret. See if they end up coming to them.
Yeah, the Batrider's Firefly is down right now, so it's kind of hard for Flipside to fight.
Spirit spotting out Flipside Tactics positioning. Secret. Not sure what they want to do now. The only way they could really force this fight is wrap around. They're going to run into a creep wave. So instead, they're just going to push mid for now, see if they can force Flipside back. But Flipside, they got a push of their own going at the bottom lane. They can easily go tier 3 at bottom. And for Secret, the ones into the defensive positioning. Mid one's just going to try and hold, and it looks like they may still try and go for some sort of wrap. But they're currently being scouted by this ward right here from Flipside Tactics.
Yeah, they have this nice ward behind them, so they know if they're wrapping around. They just want to hold this high ground area, and... Whoa.
Mass TP's back, here comes the initiation. Cito, he almost gets blown up, and he does! The relocate, not in time, and a full retreat now from Flipside Tactics. Damage just too much to Hammond. Oh, and the golem actually catches Roger in attempt to TP out. Vanscore, looks like that relocate was actually meant to go top lane, see if they can actually get some damage on that tier 3. If only he was successful in saving Cidoy, it might have been a cute maneuver. But as it is, they're going to lose 3, and Secret will gain control of the map back, and might just be able to get Roshan to their hands. It's a late Roshan, though, so they still need to wait another 30 seconds. Secret aim to try and punish Flipside before that, though, so they're going to go for the high ground, see if they can force some buybacks.
Yeah, they just got way too over-aggressive. Secret there is either coming from behind, or they're going to defend in the lane, or they're going to jump your Terrorblade, and either way, it's really, really risky, and highly unlikely that you're able to get any buildings off of that.
MP pops out, will take shot slow, but it looks like Perez gonna be brought all the way back to the fountain. Tame My Wild again seems to be trying to hold this game together. Flipside are not gonna go and blow buybacks, nor should they, as they don't have the metamorphosis anyway. They're gonna have to give up at least one lane of rack. Secret are gonna try and make it two, though.
Yeah, without the metamorphosis, it's sort of hard.
Oh, push back and a kick. But they are going to be able to catch Roger, snap him down. The long-range combination between Puppy and Midwan, but still, that was enough. Kick Secret out of the base. They only lost the top lane of Rax and a bit of damage on the Tier 3 mid. But
Yeah,
maybe they're going to lose Aegis still, actually.
They had a very small window where the Lifestealer's Rage was down. They were trying to make something happen, but without the Metamorphosis, they just have, like, no damage. They actually can't kill him.
One of the big parts was that Slardar was holding on to the gem, but fortunately, there is a refresh on the gem now, so Team Secret will still have that way to scout out the Batrider. And his all-important initiation, Flipside Tactics, scuttling forward with the Nyx Assassin, seeing if they can catch something. They've got a couple supports on the side. They see MP as well, outside of the Slardar, for now anyway. He finds his vehicle of choice, though, and Secret, and their awkward positioning, and maybe a slight opening that could have been had for Flipside Tactics, will rapidly disappear. Secret group up and stay on the high ground. Byleid Eye covering their tracks with the upheaval just in case. Even a stomp going down. Vanskor needs some help, but he won't be able to get the tether on time. Two more seconds, but he's already down. And now they've popped at this arm, but maybe MP, he's controlled up by the lasso, but mid one stops all the damage. BKB finally activated by Seedoy, and down goes MP. Flipside Tactics will manage to take out the big carry of Secret. Can they get more? Brett pops forward. Managed to get Roger, stuns him up, covering the supports track. They need a really good stomp here. Puppy's gonna get it with the help of the Golem. Midwan comes in from behind. He's already taken out the Terror Blade, and he looks for more. Two Secret. They don't need MP. They take down Flipside Tactics by themselves. Tame My Wild barely staying alive until Shadow Word finally brings him low. Midwan, he was being dumped on in the laning phase, but he shows what a menace he can be. He's got the full Invoker arsenal available to him, and he's going to push down mid lane, force out those buybacks. But it's Seedoy alone without Metamorphosis. There's no way he can really challenge Midwan here.
Yeah, at this point, with no Metamorphosis, three and Flipside down, the game is looking really grim. Almost no way they can defend this, even without the Lifestealer.
Dump it in, Threv. There's a combination. Wisp gone once again. Taking the mid lane of Brax, and Midwan's physical damage is actually off the charts with that alacrity. They should be able to make short work of bottom lane. Flipside are going to be left with one last do or die fight, and it's still going to be a 3v5 with the initiation coming out on Seedoy. Oh, is that a Manta Dodger? Maybe just a little bit short there with a Puppy ult. Either way, Seedoy doesn't take the damage, but he's being kited around quite excellently. The melee Rax is going down while he's still stuck inside the ice wall, trying to make his way back to the fountain. That'll be Megas. Flipside Tactics are gonna have to fight against the ultimate challenge, and Roger is still gonna go down. 60 seconds gone for him. Flipside Tactics now have to fight this one out, not just against Mega Creeps, but 4v5 for the next minute.
Yeah, and even if Secret did back, I'm not sure if Flipside is a lineup against the 10 versus Megas.
They've got the pullbacks. Slardar is the choice here. They're going to try and beat him to death without Metamorphosis. And it looks like they've got him too, but there is going to be the Nyx Assassin who dies to the Meteor combination from Secret. A buyback from the Slardar. He wants to end this game, and, well, they've got the numbers now for sure. Batrider dies to MP's combo. He's got the MKB as well, so they can make short work of Seedoy, who they've not caught with the stomp. He chunks down to MP's physical damage, and finally the GG is called. The series being evened out by Secret in game 2.
Team Secret, victory! Radiant's middle tower is under attack.